All right, everybody. Welcome back for another one. And I got this special edition video for you today. So I've actually been contemplating this for a while. Looking through my altcoin bag, realizing I'm just way overexposed to a bunch of stuff that we have no certainty on. And overall, I realize now that Bitcoin is clearly becoming the new global reserve asset, passing over $1 trillion in market cap. How can anything in the altcoin market compete with that? Apologies up front. You know, I've preached altcoins on this channel for months, almost a year at this point, and I truly am sorry, but I just cannot stand to continue to mislead my followers at this point. So I had to make a change. Let's check out this video and I'll show you exactly my rationale behind making this decision. All right, let's go.
April Fools! There you go, pal.
So obviously, just playing around a little because it's April Fool's Day and everyone else was getting in on the action, so I decided to as well. All right, but I am going to make the case for Bitcoin going much higher, right? Because I've always been talking about this logarithmic curve and, you know, what's going to happen when we hit this line. Are we going to pull back and follow the trend as we always have? Well, I mean, that doesn't have to happen, right? And I'm going to give you a few examples in history where we've seen this in other charts, as well as take a look at how high Bitcoin can actually go, right? If we don't follow this. But anyway, so the first example is Microsoft, right? So obviously, this is not a perfect example, but history rhymes in all assets, regardless. So as you can see here, Microsoft kind of started out with a log curve. You know, I'm sure TA, you know, technical analysts back then were arguing that, you know, as soon as it hits this top here, it's going to fall again and that's it. You know, we're going to fall out of this bubble, this dot-com bubble we're in. I'm sure that was going on in the news. All right. But what happened, right? So it hit the top here, what, 1, 2, 3, 4 times. And each time it did have a pullback afterward. Here it was again approaching in June of 96. What happened? It touched, had a little pullback, but then it just broke through, all right? And it served almost like an S-curve, right? And that's exactly what I've been saying is a potential scenario for Bitcoin, all right? So maybe it does hit the log curve again, come back down and break out. And if that happens, like I said, we're probably going to enter some ridiculous crazy dot-com times 1,000 scenario where you have all alts and Bitcoin and everything flying, all right? I will not weigh out any scenario. But coming over to Bitcoin, one thing plenty people could argue against Bitcoin is that, well, I'm not sure that this first little cycle counts, right? Starting in 2009 to 2011, basically, that was before we had any halving events, right? And that is one of the benefits of Bitcoin is it has this built-in deflationary mechanism, right? So people could argue the only history that we really need to look at is when it has its first halving on, or what has happened since then. Well, the first halving event was in the summer of 2012. What happened? The following year, Bitcoin peaks out in December, right? Same thing. 2016, 4 years later, it happens every 4 years. We had our second halving event. What happened to Bitcoin? It peaks out the following year in December of 2017. All right. So we had our third halving in 2020. We're running up close to this log curve, right? Well, if history repeats itself, we're not going to get our peak right now. We'll get our peak in December, regardless of where it goes. Obviously, we only have two peaks at this point coming off the back end of a halving. So this is like a critical moment in history to see what goes on. All right. Plus, with all the Fed printing and all countries around the globe just printing money, magical money, who knows how high these valuations can run. All right. So the one argument people could make, like I said, is, you know, take off that first 3, 4 years that we had in Bitcoin. And let's look at each halving event and on. So if you take that out of the picture, clearly you can see we're trading inside this channel. All right. Well, where does the top of this channel take us? By December, it looks like we will be reaching a peak of around 370,000 if history repeats itself, right? So will that happen? Who knows? I hope it does, because like I've said before, can you imagine the fury and rage, you know, of optimism, that euphoria going on in the crypto market with over $300,000 Bitcoin? All right, if a $10,000 to $20,000 Bitcoin drove altcoins through the roof, what's going to happen this time around? All right, so no, I'm not dumping all of my altcoins. No way. I'm positioning myself to try and capture better returns. The better returns can always be seen in altcoins, right? Especially as they move into mass adoption as well, all right? Like I've said, all this DeFi, NFT stuff, essentially none of it really has to do with Bitcoin right now. It's all being built on these smart contract platforms, all right? So we will see, but I'm sorry, if you're a Bitcoin maximalist, there's a lot more value to be found in this market outside of Bitcoin, all right? So one of the biggest mistakes I made was entering 2017 with a Bitcoin maximalist mindset. So this time around, I've been monitoring that closely and trying to pick all the best altcoins that I believe in. All right, so a couple other things I want to touch on really quick is, once again, I've shown you these before, but if you don't know about them, hopefully you do now, right? So Riot Blockchain and Marathon Patent. All right, these are two Bitcoin mining stocks, two of the biggest ones you can possibly buy shares in. They're both traded on the NASDAQ, so they can be found on any of your main brokerage platforms like Webull, Robinhood. You know, those are all the popular ones for the younger generation. But anyway, Riot and Marathon, if Bitcoin is going up towards $370,000, some ridiculous number like that, these mining stocks are going to fly, all right? So historically speaking, right, we saw Riot as low as 50 cents last year during the March Madness, no pun. Now it's trading at $50-ish. So you can see the major growth that was found there. Whoever was in on that was lucky. I rode this thing up from a dollar all the way to about 25, and that's when I jumped out. You know, I was satisfied with the returns and I moved the gains to other places. All right, so if you're still holding these stocks, congratulations. If Bitcoin goes up, you're gonna see a lot more gains. All right, a little bit different video today. Just wanted to give you a bullish take on Bitcoin. I'm not opposed to holding Bitcoin. Like I said, I just think that this entire space of digital assets and crypto is going to grow a lot bigger than just something that you buy and you hold on to, all right? That should do it for today. If you found value in the video, definitely check out my Patreon. The link is in the description below. With that, you'll get access to my Discord as well as my portfolio updates when they do happen and my trades, all right? I don't trade every single day. For me, I'm not a day-to-day trader, but when I do make a trade, it's for a significant reason. So if you want to check that out, definitely do so. Also, if you'd like to get a hold of me, the Discord is the best way to do so. I can't keep up with the YouTube comments anymore. There's a lot of scams and bots and everything always jumping in there, as well as all the negative people, and I just don't pay attention to it. So if you want to keep up with me on a personal level, check out the Discord. All right, as always, please like and subscribe, share with your friends and family, and stay tuned for the next one. Thanks.
Paper money is going away.
Yes.
And crypto is a far better way to transfer value than pieces of paper. That's for sure.
Without a doubt.
That has its pros and cons.
Just to clarify, Tesla's not going to start selling Bitcoin anytime soon.
No, we're not.
Okay. You heard it here first, even though everyone thought that.
Yeah, right.